Well, today I'm going to interview the thriller writer, the crime thriller writer, and I chose this topic because I'm really fascinated about how these people write, how they create their own world, how they build up suspense. And to just give you a brief about Vish Dhamija, the author, the writer that I'm going to interview today. Well, he wrote his first book in 2000. He finished writing his first book by 2008 or 2009. And it took him 1 year to publish his first book. There is Nothing Lasts Forever. He published his first book in 2010. And it's been a decade and he has written, he has published 10 books. It's a big deal. I mean, to just even to publish one book, to become this published writer is a big deal. But yeah, he has written 10 books. And he started this journey in Jaipur, in Rajasthan. And now he's settled in UK. To give you a brief about his the world that he creates in the book, the world is mostly Mumbai. And because Mumbai is the epicenter of Bollywood and crime and everything that's, that has drama. So yeah, that is his world, and I'll just. And yes, again, I'm doing a commenting section. Hello, sir.
Hi, Janvi. How are you?
Hi. Yes, sir. So good to see you.
Same here. I had to put on my glasses because I don't know what I'm working on. I borrowed these from my wife.
Oh, okay.
I think I'm happy with the audio of the phone.
Yeah, I think it works, yeah.
Yeah.
So, sir, I was just giving a brief about your work. And first of all, thank you so much for, you know, coming live and answering the questions that I'll be asking today. So, sir, first of all, tell me, I read somewhere about thriller books that you don't need a big idea, you just need a big how. I mean, you can just repeat the idea, but you just need a big how on how your characters will reach their destination. So is it true for thriller books?
Dekho, the truth is, and someone told me this, and I could be, it's an opinion. I'm not saying this is the hard fact. They say there are only 7 stories in the world.
In the world, yeah.
How you narrate it, how you tell that story, what characters you bring in it, what red herrings you bring in it, what twists you bring in it. Both kahaniyan remain the same. So they could be a romance, they could be a thriller, they could be a mystery, they could be a suspense, they could be a psychological or a legal. So some, if you add them together, there are 7 or 8 stories.
Yeah.
A thriller doesn't, I mean, it's no different. So you have to have a new twist or a new crime and a new
protocol.
And that's how these stories could be effective.
But sir, out of all these stories, how do you choose your world that you want to write about, say, a girl getting into some problem or a lawyer getting into some problem, or how do you choose your world?
So there are different kinds of authors that I meet every month. There are many method authors that I have met and which scare me.
Okay.
They actually do a synopsis per chapter as to how they will progress. And that is one way of writing, and that I'm sure it's a very good way. For me, what I do is I try to focus on the beginning.
Okay.
What is the crime I'm talking about? The murder or rape, kidnapping, or what will say, or theft, or burglary. And then how will it get solved? So, how would the person investigating the crime, whether it's an investigator or a police person, how will they kind of get so that is one element. Because there are 3 elements of a crime. One is from the criminal's perspective. Like the heist artist, so the entire narrative is focused on how he goes about doing this little theft.
Yeah.
Then you have the investigator, which is where the kind of both are. And the third part is, one is the crime, one is getting caught, if you are. Third is taking him or her to court.
Okay.
I kind of do the whole span. I've done books which are basically from a criminal perspective, so the narrative is like, you know, like gone. So even though he's
Okay.
Deal with him. because he is the anti-hero. And then you have the today's DC Pereira, and then you have the legal fellow, which after you have fought or wrongly fought, somebody has to take you to the court and either defend you or person.
So okay.
It's beginning and the end. That's the prime focus that I have.
Kaisa ho? Okay. And sir, as you mentioned about the villain, like I read somewhere that to test the hero, to make someone a hero, you need a worthy opponent. So how do you first try the antagonist? Do you first try the villain or first the hero? So how does that work?
Is my voice clear?
I mean, yeah, it is clear. Yeah.
Number somebody said knocked and said your voice clear. I thought I'll. So yeah, that's true, because if you just for an example, if you look at Mr. Amitabh Bachchan, there are very few villains who actually could stand up to him. Like you had Amjad Khan, you had Police Puri, then you had Darren Israel. If you put, I don't want to name anyone, but a sidey villain,
then they won't.
And that's how. So villain has to bring out the best in the hero as well. So the villain has to kind of challenge the, you know,
the hero.
And that's why Peter Brenner was born, because if you, I don't know, if you read Bendy Bazaar.
But I've read about the character.
Yeah, there was every chance that the villain, despite the gruesome act that he or she does, would have walked away with the story. And therefore, Peter Ferreira stands up big and big enough to lead the
narrative. Okay. But sir, when you are starting a novel, what are the things that you know exactly? I mean, you may not know the whole plot line, but you know your hero, you know your villain, and you know what are the other elements that you have to be sure of when you are starting it?
So beginning, I said, what is the crime we are talking about? And how will it happen? Because crime also can happen in several ways. One is, seedhe daake ghar pe chori kar lo, is one thing. Murder. And then the author has to keep in mind, do you want to show that murder? Because it's not always who done. You could show that Dhanvi has gone into a room and killed someone.
Yeah.
It will be a story because the reader doesn't know why. And how did she get caught? Or you can find that Janvi has committed the murder and carry the story till the reader kind of figures it was Janvi and no one else. So there are different elements, and some are who done it, like who did it, the others are how, the others are why.
Okay.
And sometimes you know how and why, but you're still struggling to understand that the protagonist, whoever the investigator, police, how will they catch the thing? And that is the thing. So I primarily focus on what is the crime. Is it kidnapping? Is it stalking? Is it murder? Is it rape? And how will it happen? And how will it happen? Everything else is kind of, as you go into the story, you think of subplots and twists, give some hints to the reader if they can catch it. Because it is. I think it's just honest that you need to go in some hints so that the reader should be able to catch. And some people do.
And sir, for a suspense novel to be successful, you have to always keep your audience, readers, on the edge. I mean, you want to, you know, build up the tension. And it most of the time, it starts from the first chapter. I mean, the first chapter itself is very important. So tell us, how do you write the first chapter, and what are the things that, you know, you take care when you are just introducing your characters to the readers in the first chapter?
तब ये तो आपने बिल्कुल एकदम ठीक है. ओके, नाउ वी हैविंग अ कैंडिड चैट. आई ऑलवेज राइट द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ट्वाइस.
ओके,
देयर आर ऑलवेज टू इंटरप्रिटेशंस ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इन माय केस, एंड आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट इज द राइट, दिस इज माय, एंड देन आई सी व्हिच वन काइंड ऑफ इज मोर अट्रैक्टिव और ड्रॉज द पर्सन इन. सब यू कैन राइट द सेम स्टफ ट्वाइस, बट यू कैन राइट इट डिफरेंट. Somehow, one of them is more, you know, attractive, or you know, people get drawn into it. And you have the same story.
Yeah, yeah.
Same. It is how you word it and lead questions, the lead kind of hints that people get attracted into. So my thing is, I always write the first chapter twice. I don't write every chapter twice.
Twice, but first chapter.
First chapter, first one or two chapters, I always play around which one would be more drawing people in. And that's a personal thing. And therefore, if someone says the first chapter isn't making it, it's very easy to switch over and say, you want to try it?
Okay. But sir, do you want that in the first chapter itself, readers should get that shock or surprise value? I mean, is that important to you?
Shock, surprise is one thing. But if the first two, three chapters don't hook the reader, you lost
them. Yeah.
You lost them. Because the empathy or that to start relating to either the victim or the criminal or the police. Because if that personal relationship doesn't happen in a book, then it looks like an alien story and it's another story. You need to draw them in the first three chapters. Otherwise, if you look at any literary agent across the world, they always say, send us the first three chapters.
And then,
tells them what the story is. And the first three chapters tell them, is it worth spending time on?
Okay, sir. Now your voice is cracking. I guess, sir.
I mean, headphone लगाने की कोशिश करता हूँ. Give me a second.
Okay.
I don't know how to put these, but I'll try. So, कैसे चलाऊँ?
Yeah.
I'll just try. Give me a second.
Hello.
Better.
Yeah, I think now you're audible.
Audible?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah. And sir, I just noticed that in most of the location is Mumbai. So tell us why. And I mean, we all understand that Mumbai is the place where the action happens. But what's your fascination with the city?
Okay, I normally use Delhi and Mumbai. So there are books which have Delhi as geography and their Mumbai. It is cities, and I know the city. Knowing a city is not just knowing the places. If you've lived in a city, you also know the people, how they react, what happens.
How do they react?
You need to understand ki if you come out of a building in a Mumbai flat, there will be an Istri wala, right? For Delhi, which is not true for Madras, which is not true for Calcutta. I don't know about Calcutta. Which is not true from the small place Ajmer I come from. So every building will have an Istri wala. So you then you work around ki agar koi is building mein gaya hai, for example. So you know how many people can see the villain or anyone going in and going out. So it's about knowing the place. So that's why Mumbai and Delhi are so close. I've lived in Chennai as well. So I know Chennai. Okay. A lot. So maybe next time aap bata rahe ho, so I will base the story in Chennai.
But sir, so can you sir, as a writer, have you ever chosen a location where you have not physically visited but you just read about it and then you have just put it in the book?
Yes. So sometimes when you see locations of where I take the weird places. But you can do a lot of research on the web. So, वहाँ की सड़कें. So, I have never been to in Dusra. The murder happens. The first murder happens in Antwerp. Yeah, I've not been to Antwerp. But you can see because I've been to Belgium in the, so I understand the country. But I haven't been to Antwerp ever. But you kind of create that ambience. It can happen there.
Okay. And so, do you treat your location? Do you treat your locations like characters? I mean, or no? Your main people are the main characters, not the location.
No, characters is more important than location. So you could base the same. But sometimes it has to be topical. So like in Dusra, if you're talking about diamond trade, then you would either do Mumbai, you would do Antwerp, or you'll do Tokyo because these are the three hubs for diamond trade. So you have to take a person to a place where it kind of logically sits.
Yeah.
That's the reason for locating.
And sir, I was मतलब watching one of your interviews which you recently did with Manja House, and where you said about characters. I mean, how they are important, they are crucial. So tell me, what are the things that you take care when you are writing a character sketch? What are the elements that are important when you want to write a good character?
So we, and again, there are writers who would not agree with me, but it's an opinion.
It's very relative.
You write, you write the way you write. Other, I think characters are very important because it is the because you are an author and your name is there on the book, but at the end of the day, any story is from a perspective, right? There is a narrator, even if it's not first person. So if you look at crime or whatever, any book, somebody's perspective or somebody's perception is what the narrative is. So it could be the hero or the villain or the anti-hero or whatever. And the character has to live to that that whole thing. And therefore, and people should start relating to the character. And I think if you saw the Manja House, I briefly touched upon, if you remember that film, aap to khair paida nahi hui thi tab, Shole, if you watch Shole. The reason is, long after the story was quite ordinary, and I'm not taking anything away from the story, because you got two criminals to catch a bigger criminal. But it's the entire narration and the entire built up of
that you remember, that has recall value.
Exactly. Every character had its place. So you haven't forgotten, if you've seen the movie, that little scene that Asrani is there, ki hum angrezon ke zamane ke jailer hai, it still haunts you.
You have
a little role of Jagdeep, which is hum Surma Bhopali hai, one scene. And you remember because every character is etched into your mind. And that's how I believe that if the characters stay with you, then the story will move forward.
Okay.
So therefore,
that's why I always
put work into the character, that the audience relates to the character. Iske saath itna bura kyun ho raha hai? Ye iske saath
kyun ho raha hai?
And you know, even if the character is anti-hero, for example, that movie called Dawn, both Mr. Bachchan and Mr. Khan, you are always with him. Even though you know he's doing negative stuff, you are with him because you've hooked on to him, you've related to him, and therefore he is the prime character that's leading the story. So characters are important, that to me at least.
But sir, when you write characters, do you want them to be black and white, or you just put even the hero in a gray space where, you know, he has flaws and he has things which are not desirable?
There'll always be gray space, because if you are wanting people to relate, then people relate to normal people. So Rita Ferreira, for all the glamour, she has her flaws. So she drinks, she has boyfriends after boyfriends, she does some stupid stuff, and then sometimes it's not about her wisdom, but because somebody else makes a mistake and she catches on. In High Starters, he's out and out a negative character.
Yeah.
I'm still with him.
So
now even the Akash Higurani, the character in the legal defense drama that I've started creating a series, he has his own flaws. And that's why I think I think people need to be human. Nahin toh phir wo, it goes into that ki bhai wo toh mythology hai, and it's you don't want to make your characters as semi-gods. You want them to be human.
Yeah, that's not the idea.
Then ya toh aap Superman bana do. पैंट के ऊपर कच्चा बना के निकाल दो उसे, या यू हैव ऑर्डिनरी कैरेक्टर्स, यू आर ह्यूमन, एंड देयरफॉर अदर ह्यूमन बीइंग्स विल रिलेट टू.
Yeah, and sir, as you mentioned about the character of Rita, I mean, she is this detective, and you mentioned in one of your interviews that women can be better detectives. So when you're writing books, does the gender of your protagonist matter? I mean, do you give a second thought on, you know, that you want it to be female or you want it to be male? Does How important is that?
So, देखो पहले नहीं सोचता था, but इतना लोगों ने पूछ लिया कि now I have started thinking about it. So, Rita was born, seriously, it wasn't kind of कि मैंने सोचा था male या female. But like I said, when I started writing Bhindi Bazaar, there was every chance, and I really recommend you read that book, and you'll understand that the villain could have walked away with all the glory. So you needed someone who could stand tall and big and then lead the narrative rather than the villain leading the narrative. And therefore Rita was born.
Okay.
And when I was there for the launch of Bhendi Bazaar in Chennai, it was, I mean, the Bhendi Bazaar was launched by the ex-IG of Chennai. And he, and somebody asked me why a woman and, you know, X, Y, Z. Logically, I would have asked them, ki agar main aadmi bana deta, to tum yehi sawal pooch rahe hote, why not woman? So, you know, people why will ask you anything. So he came, says, see, detective, you know, there are two elements to it. One is detective. Detection and one is deduction. So he and his word, he says men are very good at detecting. So they'll go and find something. But
find
when you
something.
Put all those clues on the table, a woman does better deduction ki ye fit ho raha hai, ye fit nahi ho raha. So
nahi
women
ho raha.
Are better at deduction. So you bring them all the clues, a woman will do a better job. That's what his word.
So, मतलब पहले you were not thinking on the gender part, but now I think the.
अब इतने लोगों ने पूछ लिया तो one has to get conscious कि भाई क्यों रखा है. And then I have been and somebody read one book out of the blue and he says he doesn't. मतलब one of the newspapers, not that I agree with them. He says he always gives a very small role to women. And I'm saying, तुमने रीटा फरेरा पढ़ी है पूरी किताब उसकी है उसके बाद
people
will come up with it. So they'll read one and they say, oh, women have got a small role.
Yeah.
No, the whole series which has got picked up by TV is woman. So it's not men. Gender bias वो लोग अपने आप लगा लेते हैं.
Okay. Yeah, it's very relative, subjective to And sir, I was wondering, like, whenever an artist creates anything, be it a painting or a movie or a book, they might have some idea whether they want to just entertain, whether they want to make a stand, whether they want to be take a political stand, anything. So when you're writing, is there a subconscious layer, a subconscious thing that, you know, you want to speak about this topic, whether it's child trafficking?
Largely, all writers are for entertainment. उसमें थोड़ा बहुत ज्ञान तो दे ही देते हैं मैं कुछ इट्स नॉट अ सेल्फ हेल्प इट्स नॉट ऑटोबायोग्राफी इट्स नॉट गुड वर्सेस बैड इट इज शेयर एंटरटेनमेंट लाइक यू गो एंड सी अ मूवी वो फिल्म में भी यू गो फॉर योर टू एंड हाफ थ्री आवर्स ऑफ एंटरटेनमेंट ऑन अ नेटफ्लिक्स सीरीज यू हैव एट और नाइन आवर्स ऑफ एंटरटेनमेंट अ बुक इज बेसिकली स्पेशली बिकॉज आई एम राइटिंग इन अ जॉनर विच इज जस्ट एंटरटेनमेंट एंड थ्रिल सो दैट इज द पर्पस नाउ उसमें से कोई समवन कैन टेक आउट अ गुड पार्ट आई विल बी मोर देन हैप्पी टू से क्या मैंने लिखा था इसलिए बट आई
गेट
इट्स इट्स शेयर एंटरटेनमेंट
ओके So yeah, I mean, it is, you are as clear when you are writing the book that you primarily want it for entertainment value. Okay.
Primarily is entertainment. Yeah. उसके बाद किसी को कोई भी मतलब निकालना है. I'm not suggesting people should do crime. हाँ.
Okay. Great. And sir, like I was talking to a lyricist in Ahmedabad, and I just knew that he maintains a memory log. Like if say I'm meeting you, and if I see different characteristics, I'll just jot it down so that in future, if I'm writing something, I can use it. So do you maintain anything so that, you know, it helps you when you are writing your next book?
Yes, I do. So what I do is, मेरी memory इतनी अच्छी नहीं है, तो what I do is I make a point on my iPhone. Because you observe a lot of things, 12, 13 hours of waking life in a day. And it is common to lose that track. So what I do is I make a small note on my iPhone, which, you know, acts as a reminder when next time when I sit to write, is it usable? Did I see somebody? Ab maine Janvi ko dekha, jiske baal thode se dekh lo. The next character can have those wavy hair. Just an impression.
Yeah.
Or the way people talk, or way people behave. So you, instead of capturing it in my memory, because you know there's a limit to the RAM or hard drive. So what I do is I take a note on my iPhone, and what notes kind of come into the computer straight away because wo aajkal to everything fine. And then when you're writing, and if you want to have a new character, or want to describe something, or for simple thing. किसी घर में कर्टन अच्छे लगे आपको All you do is take a picture, put it in your notes, or describe a little bit. And next time you know how to kind of, if you want, have a scene where you need dark curtains, that's the curtain you saw. But so everyone makes notes. You could make mental notes, or you could make notes on your iPhone. Try to do that. Okay. Yeah, everyone does that.
Yeah. And so when you have all those details, how, when you're writing a book, what sort of details you want to give to your readers? Like, do you really want to give like a one page detail on, say, what the character was thinking or how the house was? Like, kitna, how much information do you want to give?
So, my endeavor, main chahta ye hu ki the person should be dropped into the scene.
Yeah.
So, it should, when you're reading, you should be immersed into the text. Ki bhai wo, do you feel you are there? Can you feel your pulse riding because somebody is threatening Rita or anyone, the protagonist? Agar aapko ye dar nahi lag jaye ki iske saath ab kya hoga, as long as you can make it that real, then you achieve the purpose. So that is my goal, ki I try to drop, and uske liye jitni detail deni pade. So it's not pages after pages of the curtains or the walls. But you know, if you're driving through, then let people be in the car. When the protagonist or the hero or villain or whoever takes the left, and if you are in Mumbai, you know ki yaar ye left hai yahan pe. So it kind of, you know, one thing. Mera dekho headphone gir gaya. Aapki baat to waqt pata nahi kaha. Main leke aaunga to isse mil gaya tumhe. Anyway, one ear is enough. Hello, can you hear me?
Works,
I'll just find the headphone. Pata nahi kaha gaya. Ye bada problem hai. Anyway, I can't.
Okay.
So I'll have to. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Hmm. Yeah, I can. Yeah.
Ah, okay.
So, one thing I read, I mean, Wikipedia se leke aapke jo online interviews publish hue the, everyone wrote about how you are based in UK. So tell me, how has UK, has it or has it not influenced what you are writing, how you are building characters or how you are narrating a story? Has it impacted? Or you don't think there is a connection?
No. Okay. I think geography doesn't make a difference. This would have been true 20 years ago. Ab aap aur main, we sitting across countries and talking and looking. You are. I mean, in my mind, in the same room. That difference of geography is actually kind of gone away now. You had to be there for the book launch. Aaj ki tarikh mein, nobody wants to see the author. Book hai, pasand aayegi, le lenge. I don't think that matters so much as if that mattered 20 years ago. Yeah.
Okay. And then, sir, when it comes to writing style, suspense novel, do you think that it should not have voice when you're writing it? You need to have a certain writing style so that it is more engaging to the readers. मतलब प्लॉट तो सही है बट राइटिंग स्टाइल पे क्या मतलब वो व्हाट शुड बी कंसीडर्ड
आई थिंक इट मैटर्स बिकॉज यू नीड टू क्रिएट दैट यू नो कि अब क्या होगा व्हाट नेक्स्ट सो मर्डर हो गया या रेप हो गया या किडनैपिंग हो गई या बर्गलरी होगी तो व्हाट नेक्स्ट सो बेसिकली यू नीड टू कीप पीपल ऑन देयर टोज व्हेन दे आर रीडिंग कि नेक्स्ट चैप्टर डजंट मीन टू बी What will happen next is somehow you need to keep that curiosity alive with people. What's happening? Because otherwise the story would go into a mundane thing, ki yaar ye to chal raha hai, to chale ja raha hai. And we all read those books where pages badhte jao, kahani move hi nahi karte. The kahani has to move. You have to create that kya hoga, plus the and also be descriptive about what is around you. But the story has to keep moving. Unlike some of the, you know, wo serial aate hai na ki wo chaar hafte baad pakdo, to kahani wahi ki hoti hai. Sab gehne badle. So basically, you need to move the story. And story has a pace. At some point, if it gets too slow, people will drop off. And if it's too fast.
So I was just saying that when you are maintaining this pace and when you are writing the story, how much of creative license do you take? I mean, when it comes to places or when it comes to describing things, just because it's a fiction novel, I mean, do you just write what you want to? Or
so as long as, I mean, as far as the places and the location go, I mean, jo building ma hai, wo to hai. You can't take it. Okay. You can describe it in your own words, whether you like it or you don't like it, or you बाप उसको ब्राउन बोलना जरूरी नहीं है, यू कैन से अ शेड ऑफ मड और व्हाटएवर, बट यू डोंट हैव मच क्रिएटिव लाइसेंस अनलेस इट्स अ फैंटेसी, बिकॉज उसमें तो आप एवरीथिंग इज वाजिब,
कुछ भी
हैरी पॉटर में तो सभी कुछ कुछ भी नहीं हो सकता,
सभी कुछ,
बस इट 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 इज नॉट रियल, इट हैज टू बी रियलिस्टिक. कि अगर आप क्राइम बता रहे हो, क्राइम बता भी रहे हो, तो हो सकता है वो क्राइम कभी नहीं हुआ हो, नहीं हो सकता हो, लेकिन नहीं होगा, बट थिंग इज क्या वो हो सकता है, इवन देयर इज अ 10% पॉसिबिलिटी और अ प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ये हो सकता है, देन इट इज रियलिस्टिक एंड यू प्ले विद द रियलिस्टिक एलिमेंट ऑफ इट, नॉट द रियल, बिकॉज रियल तो वो ट्रू क्राइम हो गया, और
ट्रू क्राइम
द अदर वे अराउंड इज टोटल फैंटेसी, सो इट हैज टू बी रियलिस्टिक, इज दिस इज
प्ले इन द मिडिल ग्राउंड,
इट हैज टू बी पॉसिबल, वेदर इट कैन, वेदर इट हैज हैपेंड और इट विल नेवर हैपन इज बिसाइड्स द पॉइंट, बट इज इट पॉसिबल एंड दैट्स द रियलिस्टिक एलिमेंट. People should believe कि this can happen.
Okay. Yeah. And then sir, I mean, for people who have just written one or two books, I mean, things are different. But you have written 10 books. So tell us that how do you make sure that you don't repeat yourself? Like before starting a new book, do you just make a list of things that ये चीजें तो नहीं ही लिखनी, because you've already mentioned about it or written about it, described it in your earlier books. How do you make sure that you know you're not just are doing the same thing that you've done before?
Uska, I think the thing is because I don't remember what I've already written. So anything that comes is fresh. So ho sakta hai kuch ekad kuch repeat ho jata ho. And especially if it's in a series. So if you write another one of Rita Ferreira, which is the fourth one I've written, there are certain elements that you need to bring. In fact, I was editing the fourth one and I have to check uska rank kya dikhaya tha pichle wale mein. Because ASP has to be ASP. Inspector थोड़ी बना दोगे आप. So yeah, there could be some repetition, but because वो 10 साल पहले जो लिखा था वो तो आपको भी याद नहीं है. So if it comes to you again, it'll anyway be in a different package.
Yeah.
हो सकता वही क्रीम हो, but it'll be a new bottle. So if you don't realize you've written it again, no chance that the reader would realize. I don't copy stuff from my old books, वो क्यों करूँगा, but अगर
नहीं नहीं वो सब it's very subconscious sometimes.
हाँ, and the same thing might occur to you again, but I can guarantee you it will not happen in the same words. वो कैसे होगा? The thought will be there, thought might get repeated, but the words will not.
Okay, yeah.
That consistency will remain.
Is there? Okay. And so whenever we are talking about writing, we always romanticize it, saying ki mood hoga tab likhenge and all of that. But tell us that does writing need discipline? And if yes, then what sort of things that you do to, you know, make sure that, because it's your profession. So what discipline do you maintain to write a book?
So it's not a profession, mera. It's I enjoy it. And there needs to be some discipline. Wo kya hai ki I have met enough number of people who meet me and say ki hum bhi ek kitab likhna chahte hain. And my only question is to likho. But you have to write for someone else to see. To wo discipline to hai ki if you have a story in your mind, and I honestly believe that every single person on this planet has at least one story. Bhai ek kahani to har koi likh sakta hai. Par wo more than half, 90% of people don't even begin.
Yeah.
Another 5% begin and let it be there. वो आगे उसके आधा लिख के ना छोड़ देते. So you have discipline. मेरा ये है कि I normally like to write in the mornings. So आज भी जैसे I got up at 6:30, I came and I started writing. I did a scene. I do not force myself to write. So before this COVID happened, so there's this cafe behind my house, a Turkish cafe. तो मैं वहां जाता हूँ, एक कॉफी ले लेता हूँ, दो तीन घंटे बैठा रहता हूँ. उसने मुझे he's giving me his wifi code. He doesn't bother me कि एक ही कॉफी पी रहा है और तीन घंटे बैठा है. He's a nice guy. And I write. Sometimes I finish a scene. Sometimes I finish a full chapter, 2-3 scenes. Sometimes I just hang around there and क्या करता हूँ, मैं पिछले चैप्टर को एडिट करके आ जाता हूँ. Because there's nothing new happening.
Okay.
It's not a question of a block or something. But sometimes if you're not getting the idea कि आगे स्टोरी को कैसे बढ़ाऊँ, because you know the for me, I know the beginning and the end. But you need to have interesting stuff in the middle. If the stuff that you're thinking of is not interesting or it's not progressing the story, wo sirf lag kar raha hai sirf batane mein, तो आई गिव इट अ ब्रेक. इसमें कोई वो नहीं है कि मतलब ओके सी आई एम नॉट अंडर एनी टाइमलाइन कि आपको कल तक तो ये सबमिट करना है, नहीं तो बहुत आ जाएगा. सो यू टेक योर टाइम, पुट योर बेस्ट फुट फॉरवर्ड. इफ इट टेक्स मोर देन 6 मंथ्स, इट टेक्स मोर देन 6 मंथ्स.
ओके ओके,
सो डोंट पुश योरसेल्फ, इट हैज टू कम नेचुरली.
Naturally, yeah, yeah. I'm, like writing is not the thing where you can just push yourself. Yeah, true, true, true. And sir, a few of the last questions. Sir, tell us about the importance of editing. How much do you edit your books after you've written the first draft?
So I write the first draft. Reads it and tells me, "ये hole है, ये murder और करो, ये करो, वो करो."
एक murder और कर दो.
एक murder और कर दो. ये ठीक नहीं लग रहा. एक काट को तो और मारो, खड़काओ. And then I do the first round. Then I have a friend here called Patrick. उसको मैं देता हूँ, he kind of edits it, तो he kind of edits and he tells me कि यार पहले तो तूने brown eyes दिखाई थी, अब तेरी eyes grey हो गई, you know those kind of things. और ये बाल पहले तो ऐसे घुंघराले दिखाए थे, अब सीधे दिखा दिए, क्या मतलब? You need to kind of get the align. And he also does the proofreading kind of कि वो अगर you know comma गलत है या you know language गलत, so all those things he does. Then I send it to my literary agent. She also gets it read and then she tells me कि ये पहले तीन चैप्टर में मजा नहीं आ रहा, तो ये सेकंड चैप्टर को टाइट कर दो, यू नो, बिकॉज़ रिमेंबर वी स्पोक अबाउट फर्स्ट, ये दूसरा फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज ड्रैगिंग ऑन, कंडेंस इट, ये जो आपका बाकी का है तो छठे चैप्टर में लगा दो, तो कहानी वहां भी बन जाएगी. सो मूव इट फास्ट,
तोड़ मरोड़ के.
हाँ, बिकॉज गेट लेट पीपल हुक्ड ऑन एंड देन बाद में बताओ ना ये सब, ये पहले क्यों बता रहे हो कि इसमें आदमी अटक जाएगा तो कहानी नहीं पड़ेगा. देन इट गोज टू द पब्लिशर, देन पब्लिशर का एडिटर भी उसमें कराता है कि भाई ये तो गलत है, ये बाद में आना चाहिए, ये पहले आना चाहिए, ये काम कर दो, ये वर्ड्स बहुत ज्यादा है. बेंडी बाजार ओरिजिनली वर 120,000 वर्ड्स.
ओके,
हाँ, तो वो काट 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 के 85,000 पे आ गई. ये काट दो, वो काट दो, ये काट दो, काट. सो आई स्ट्रॉन्गली बिलीव इन एडिटिंग एंड आई विल टेल यू
व्हाई.
बिकॉज फॉर अ राइटर, मुझे लगता है मैंने तो एकदम गजब लिख दिया, नोबडी कैन फाइंड अ फॉल्ट. But you need to get professionals, editors, who understand कि भाई बहुत अच्छा है,
इसकी ज़रूरत नहीं, हाँ,
इतना चाहिए नहीं.
Why
are you over eager to explain when it's not required? So and they are professionals. They know, they sell the books, they know everything. So I think everyone should definitely listen to editors, because at the end of the day, your job is to write, their job is to present the material. So maybe because you are flowing, आप तो लिखते चले जाओगे, तो कोई तो उसे कहेगा ना कि ये भी उसके लायक है, ये बाकी को हटाओ. So I believe in it. I have no ego than that. If somebody tells me with a reason, not because कि यार
उसको अच्छा नहीं लग रहा
है, हाँ, ये थोड़ी हुआ. You need to have a reason कि भाई ये क्यों नहीं ठीक हुआ. ठीक है, तो चेंज कर दो.
Okay, okay. And sir, tell us, what are you writing these days? I mean, if you can just give us a brief.
I have finished the 4th Rita Ferreira, उसका नाम, which is tentatively I've titled called Showtime.
Okay,
वो has gone to my editor, and I am writing a book about a con man, कि वो चोर चकारी है, वो ताश खेलता है और ताश में चुराइयां करता है, ऐसे काम. तो I'm trying to write that, which I've kind of, I've just barely started, so वो अभी शुरू किया, after I finish Rita Ferreira.
Yeah, and sir, how important are titles of the book for you? I mean, do you really, you know, take suggestions? Yeah, जो भी instinctively आता है वही.
No titles. When I started, I thought I'll have titles which are, you know, have some. I strongly, you've written the story. The title will come out of there, not the other way around.
Yeah.
Unless obviously you know, तो जैसे मैंने जो अभी लिख रहा हूँ वो मैंने एक टाइटल से शुरू की, आफ्टर 10,000 वर्ड्स, 11,000 वर्ड्स, आई डिसाइडेड टाइटल भी गलत है, सो आई चेंज द टाइटल एंड देयरफॉर चेंज द नैरेटिव. वो नैरेटिव हैज टू काइंड ऑफ, एवरीथिंग हैज टू टाई
गो विद द टाइटल.
हां, एग्जैक्टली, द टाइटल हैज टू गो विद इट एंड दैट हैज टू गो विद दैट.
ओके ओके ओके. सर, एनी ऑफ योर फेवरेट टाइटल्स ऑफ ऑल द बुक्स दैट यू हैव रिटन?
Bindi Bazaar. So it comes from that place in Mumbai. Deja Karma, I think I'm quite happy with that. Your deja vu or karma ka, because the karma repeats itself.
Sir, I mean, I have covered most of the questions, but is there anything I missed out on that you would like to add?
Aap kya likh rahe ho?
सर मैं बस न्यूज़पेपर के लिए आर्टिकल्स लिख रही हूँ एंड आई एम जस्ट लाइक आई हैव नो एस्पिरेशंस टू राइट अ बुक बट जस्ट आई एम जस्ट इन ओ ऑफ राइटर्स आई जस्ट वांट टू नो मोर अबाउट देयर क्रिएटिव प्रोसेस हाउ डू दे राइट व्हाट दे राइट बिकॉज़ सर राइटिंग फॉर अ न्यूज़पेपर इज वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम राइटिंग अ बुक दैट्स व्हाई
आई मीन आई यूज्ड टू वर्क फॉर